Welcome back to Changing Latitudes. Today, we're going to run some electrical wire from here to this well that services our reservoir and will bring up the water to our irrigation system. Stick with us. As I said, we're going to run some electrical wire from this lighthouse all the way down to the well at the reservoir. So it's about 450 feet, and we're running some 8 wire through some conduit. I had unfortunately filled this trench, which I would have used for the common purpose of the French drains and the irrigation and the electrical, but I had filled it all up before I even knew I was going to do this project. So I've had to unfortunately dig all the rock back out of the hole and so that I could put it in. Now it'd only be at the section that I have put in the French drain. It'd only be about 6 inches deep, but it'll be underneath this rock and under a paver. So I'm gonna fudge it just a bit there. Probably should be further down by code. Now, after I get past the part where I had filled it in right here, we will dig it down all the way to the 18 inches in conduit, so it should be fine all the way down from that point on. So looking to get this done today. Never a joy to pull eight four wire through conduit, but it should be a little bit easier because we're going to do it on the driveway today than the last time when I pulled it all the way down to the shop by the street. come out to the shop to assemble, if you will, the joint point between the line coming from the lighthouse down to the well, as well as the line continuing on to our yellow shop in the distance. So I'm going to need also another hole for a possible, don't know if I'm going to do it yet, hookup for a gate in some future state, so the electrical will be ran over to it. So what I'm going to do with this electrical box here is I'm going to cut some holes into the bottom, you know, to fit this guy here, this 1-inch connector. And so that we can have all the lines come into the box, marry. I have some nice splice, you know, electrical splices that should work as well. So it'll be able to, you know, receive the four lines in, the 3/8 and the 1/10 ground, and you know, meld them all together as you would electrically speaking. Now this is I'm going to go ahead and glue this guy in. When I get it in, I'm going to put some glue down, glue it up to it, and then, you know, fasten it down tightly with one of these all. So I've got to be making sure that I got enough room to turn that all in the bottom, and I will, you know, I'll make sure that happens. So I'm going to go ahead and have that, so a nice little rubber water seal on that. I'm not saying it's an overly official 101 electrical, make sure it's perfect, but I think we're going to be fine on it. It's going to be inside of a box, a ground box, as well as I'm going to have it up on a hill, a little bit of a little bluff, so that it can, you know, any water that, you know, snow and what have you will bleed off of it. So that's what I'm doing out here today, and yeah, get her done. So I'll make this be the inbound coming from the lighthouse. This or the other, I'm thinking it's this guy here, is gonna go out to the yellow shop, and then this guy here will go out to some possible future gate, if you will. And then this will be the line coming back out into the well. So I figure that'll give me enough room as these two come feeding in and this one comes in. And the connector I have is a 1-to-3 ratio. So it should be such that the wiring comes up, connects to the four others, and yeah, should be good. Okay, drill away. Excellent hole drills, by the way. My dad's done a nice job of investing in a lot of good stuff. So, very fortunate to have these available to me when you need them. Okay, so other than cleaning up the mess, I think this end of this project's done. I'm going to take it back up to the house and glue up the four parts. It's the next morning and it's now time to hook up this well. You know, started this project actually all the way back in October when we put the well in and for the reservoir. As you've seen in the videos in the past on the reservoir, quite a bit of work done on here on this property for this water source, but you know, that's to work out on another date. This line going all the way up to the top, not only do I have the water line, but I have the electrical line that'll feed into the two points onto the well. Like I was just showing you, I have built this guy here for the electrical hookup. And it'll sit somewhere out about here, put in, like I say, the well connection and also the gate possibility and the yellow shop off in the distance there. And then of course the feed from the lighthouse where the live wire will come in. I also put together this valve system so that we can have the water obviously hook up to the well, go back up to the lighthouse to, you know, make sure that the pressure and all the water is being delivered. And then this will be the outflow for winterizing. I'll have that cut in and dropped into the creek so that the water goes back out and, you know, line's completely clear. So, you know, we do have frost heave here, so we got to make sure that the line is cleared out and as well doesn't, you know, freeze inside the line and break the line. So I'm going to get to it. Here we go. This is where the big boys come in because I got to work this out straight. I think I'm going to go ahead and put this line in here. Maybe I cut it back there first. I don't know. There's going to be quite a bit of play in it. But I kind of need the water line first so that it'll give me good guidance on how to land the electrical, because they are going to stay in the same box. So it doesn't really matter if it's 5 feet out, 10 feet out. It looks like because of that area there, I should probably be in that space somewhere. So, yeah, let's do that. Let's cut back there and then hook up this bad boy. And, okay, so what do we have here? We have the water outbound to the lighthouse and the pump station to, you know, run the irrigation. We got the water coming back into the well to pull the water from the reservoir. And this is the discharge for winterizing. We have the wire coming in from the lighthouse. And then we have the wire going out to the yellow shop. And then a future stub out for possible someday. A gate for our driveway. And then of course we have the electrical setup, preset up for the wire to go in and run the pump out of the well. So we're all staged. What I'm going to do is wrap up this wire, put the box on top of it, have Ron come over and fill it up.
would call that golden.
Yep.
What do you think, man?
They'll never know you're here.
Yeah, right.
This has been irritating me all winter.
This spot.
Now I'm up here at the lighthouse, ready to put together this plumbing into it for the irrigation piping that came up for that well down in the valley next to the reservoir, and also the electrical. So I'll go to work on both those items to make sure that we're fully connected on this end. Now, when I say fully connected, I'm not really talking about all the hardware that's going to be necessary inside the lighthouse. I'm going to postpone that and come back to it at a later time. I'm just going to get it to where it goes inside the base of this lighthouse, get it in there plumbed in so that it's ready for the next phase, which would include the hardware. So let's flip them real quick and take a look. So it's this guy here that's coming up from the reservoir. We got the electrical lines and the water line. And then I've already done some digging in this area. And of course I've got a hole down there at the bottom that needs to be enlarged. So I'll be going to work on that. Inside the lighthouse is where that's gonna come in. And of course I've got my sub panel already connected. And this board here is the future site of all the hardware that would support the pump down there by the reservoir. On the other side of this wall is some of the irrigation outflow. So what will eventually happen, not necessarily today, I will come from that hole right there, down there, and run across to the bottom, through the bottom, to this guy. But of course along the way stopping at a pressure tank, as well as again the control hardware. Some valves and what have you will be laced in here. So we'll get that all done. I didn't choose wisely. Of course, there's some rebarb right here, and I'm gonna have to cut through that. You know, the one drill bit does cut through that, but now I've got a kind of a bar sitting there, so I'm gonna go ahead and knock that out. I've chipped everything else around it, so hopefully the multi-tool will make some fast work of it, and we'll be on our way to actually plumbing this thing.
wrap on this project. Electrical's at least to both ends. I'll finish off on the lighthouse when we get ready to pump the water out of the reservoir. Thank you for watching. See you soon.